Unity stands for unity. Unity. UNITY stands for unity. UNITY. Zoom, zoom, zoom. I'm listening to that Queen Latifah song. Alright, so. Of which I didn't even know it was Queen Latifah that sang it until quite recently when I was compiling a playlist of all Pisces musicians. And I was like, ooh, she did what? And that song came for the face, so you guys go listen to it, okay? There's also something spirit to say that Aquarians, like you guys are, you can be quite stubborn, especially when it comes to messages. But then, with music, with movies, with media, you're able to easily flow in and grab your message, okay? So go listen to that song. UNITY stands for unity. Alright, let's see what happens for the Aquarians in here. What's going on? Mm-hmm. What's starting here for Aquarians? We're just rebranding the brand. You're getting a new lease on how you shop in your relationships. There's something coming through around transformation. You're transforming your role in your relationships, from your personal relationships to your work relationships. Your role, for some of you, you got like a job raise or promotion and stuff before this new one. But now under this new moon in Libra, you'll be getting, and over the next 6 months leading up to the full moon in Libra, you'll be getting the chance to really integrate that transformation. To really, really integrate that transformation. You know, it's like you've been told, okay, you're the manager, but now you're becoming the manager. You're the CEO. Now you're becoming the CEO. You're the entrepreneur. Now you're becoming the entrepreneur. So what I'm also hearing is like there'll be trials, there'll be challenges that will help you to own and secure your power better. So this is going to be a very wild ride for the next 6 months, a very transformative wild ride. I'm 6 months in. Okay, I know. Because it's not just about being called something. It's you about knowing that you are that thing. So as I said, you guys, for some of you, your raise or your promotion might have come as a surprise, okay? You got some gifts, and gifts are still coming in for you. So you've got seven of Swords, okay, so commit to the idea that you deserve good things. So that's why I said about that transformation. It's like you now, because there's been this detachment from it. Like, okay, yeah, you were told you become this, or you recently got this, but you are still not seeing yourself as that. So over the 6 months, you'll get the time to really, really sink in and seep in, and allow this new transformation to seep into every cell of your body. So commit to the idea that you deserve good things. Don't think that this was a fluke. Don't think that you're going to fail in this new role with these new responsibilities. Don't think that it was a mistake. Don't think that you'll be seen as a fraud or you'll be called out. No. Release your worries and your fears that you are pulling you down. Accept this gift. Accept this gift and know that it comes with its own growth requirements. Know that it comes with its own growth requirements. It comes with its own challenges, but not challenges that overpower you. Okay? These are things that are going to help you grow. These are situations and scenarios that are going to like trigger your growth. Because the more you're able to make decisions and challenging situations, the more you improve your decision-making skills, the more you improve your critical thinking skills, the more you improve your strategic thinking skills. So you are being made to think on a higher level or that. Okay? This is time for you to rest assured in yourself and what you're capable of and what you can do. Know yourself. Don't try to overplan also. Don't try to overplan. This is great for you. Accept it. Be satisfied with your process. Be satisfied with how things are going. Know that every day brings you an opportunity for you to learn. Know that every day gives you the opportunity for you to practice, for you to focus on improving your skills, for you to focus on getting better, on connecting the dots, on seeing the bigger picture. No, there is no perfect manager or perfect boss or perfect entrepreneur or perfect expert or perfect creator. Everybody starts from one day. Nobody was born perfect. Like, yeah, we came into this world as perfect cute babies, but that's part of our journey in this world also. That's part of our growth in going through all of these changes, which help us to harness and realize our potential and our purpose. So congratulations, my sweet Aquarius. Don't be afraid of this. Also, don't be afraid of making mistakes. Don't hold yourself too rigidly to the fact that, oh, you've been entrusted with this thing, so you have to be careful. You have to dot all your T's. You have to cross. You have to cross your T's, touch your I's. But then, if you don't make any mistake, how will you grow? It's like a... So if you're just driving along the highway, there's no scenery, no bump, no curves. It's just one straight road. That seems to be a very, very, very boring road trip. But imagine if there were stops, if there were toll gates, if there was scenery, if you had to take a winding curve, if the road was blocked at a point, or your vehicle broke down, or their parent would. All those details are what brings in the adventure, what brings in the interest, and what those are the things that teach you, those are the things that elevate your perspective, because you'll be able to have scenarios to pull from. Like, oh, when that thing happened, this was how we did. So what if we try it in this different way? I've seen that this thing, if we do it this way, it can work. What if? So be grateful for those obstructions, be grateful for those detours, be grateful for the delays, be grateful for the trials, the challenges, because they are helping you to refine and own your confidence and your mastery and your expertise and hearing. So trust yourself, trust in what you're bringing to the table, commit to the idea that you deserve good things. You guys may be drinking a lot more coffee, I'm saying Starbucks. Not to promote them or anything, but what I'm just saying is that you guys may be drinking a lot more coffee. Try not to get in over your head. Ask for help when you need to. Be very open. But be very open to support also. But right now, just know that in the process, in 6 months' time, then you'll be a badass. Like, now it feels foreign to you. But in 6 months' time, because you would have gone through so much growth in the process, in 6 months' time, you're going to feel very, very sure of yourself. You're going to be very confident in what you bring to the table. You're going to be very confident in making decisions, okay? 6 months, baby. You go 7, 8, 9. 7, 8, 9, UNITY. So let's see. What archetype can you embody that will help you to be more confident as you go through these changes and as you commit to your process of growth? You guys may also be receiving a lot more surprises, like gifts associated with this promotion, but also in this period, just be open to receiving gifts. It could be little gifts, it could be huge gifts, but they are going to come as surprises to you, the self. You don't need to embody anybody other than yourself. I know that from yourself there comes a multi-dimensional, like you're not a single being, you're multi-dimensional. Okay, your radiance shines across multiple fields of vision. There are so many things you've not even, like, that you're not even capable. There are so many things you're not aware that you're capable of until you find yourself in those situations that require you to bring out those skills from within. And you'll be like, oh, so I had this in me. Of course you had it in you, just never had the opportunity to use it, so it lay dormant. But over this next 6 months, you are going through a journey of, as I said, transformation. transmutation, really up leveling in the way you see yourself, really up leveling in the way you allow yourself to be, to allow yourself to shine, to allow yourself to be confident, to allow yourself to be out there. So release your worries that you'll be found as a fraud, release your worries that you may not be enough. Release your worries that you may fumble the role. Release your worries that you may fumble your responsibilities. No, none of those shit. You guys, you could also buy pearls. So it's something about the beauty of pearls that will keep you calm at this time. Then also buying, also wearing, wear a lot more colors. A lot more colors will make you feel more powerful. There's also something about you holding yourself back from maybe not wearing so much colors because you feel attention is going to be on you. Of course, attention is on you. Yeah, you. You're one of one. There's nobody else like you in the world. Did you get that? There's nobody else like you in the world. So yes, over the next 6 months, you'll be feeling pulled to wearing a lot more colors, being a lot more colorful, being very vivid, wanting to leave an impression in people's minds. But you'll be leaving impressions consciously or unconsciously. So choose how you appear, choose and give yourself grace. There's just every emphasis on giving yourself grace as you go through this period. You're not perfect. You've never gone through this journey. So give yourself grace to learn and unlearn. Give yourself grace to learn and unlearn. It's also something about you constantly having to make choices like, okay, so this thing I'm doing, does it benefit who I am now or does it benefit who I was before? So it's almost like you have to weigh your decisions, all your decisions against that standard. This thing I'm considering, this action I want to take, does it benefit who I was? Who I was, playing small, why I didn't want to be seen, why I didn't want to acknowledge, and who didn't want to acknowledge our needs, these needs. Do they benefit and support that old version of me, or do they benefit and support this new version of me? So this 6 months is going to require you to also make a lot of decisions. It's like every day, as I said, decision-making skill is going to be enhanced and improved, and you're going to be able to use it in your personal life as well as in your work life. Excuse me. I need to be making a lot of decisions. I'm feeling ambivalent. Sometimes you feel pulled in two different ways. But one thing that will always help you to stay grounded is, am I making this decision for who I am now? Am I making this decision for who I once was? You're going to be focusing on yourself a lot over this next 6 months. So give yourself space, give yourself grace to grow. You're growing, you're learning, you're mastering your skill, you're finding your own way, you're making your own life, you're building your own life for yourself. So give yourself the space and time. Commit incredulously to yourself. Be very selfish about yourself, your growth, your development, your progress. Focus on yourself. That's the relationship you're working on over the next 6 months. Yourself, your relationship with yourself. Your relationship with yourself. Your relationship with yourself. Spirit is saying I should just leave it at that. Because normally you will even be stubborn. You know what's watching this reading to the end. So I'm going to keep it short and brief, okay? You guys may be seeing 789, as I said. You're wearing a lot more colors. Wear a lot over the up to March next year. Up to March next year, do things you normally would not do. Be unconventional from who you were, not unconventional from whatever the world standards is. You know, unconventional from who you once were. You yourself, you had the standards, so you let go. What that mean in the past? Is that what the past version of you that felt comfortable doing? Okay. So what does this new version of me want to try out? Can you hear that? I am committed to bringing forth my greatness. I will no longer be small. Baby, it's time to stamp it. Can you see the colors? Can you see the way the colors are radiating out? No, you're no longer playing small. You're allowing your colors to shine through. I see your true colors shining true. I see your true colors. That's why I love you. Don't be afraid. Do, 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 do. I see your true colors. True colors. True colors shining through. I think I'm on that last part. There's also something about when you start doubting. Okay, when doubts or anxieties try to creep in, talk to a friend who you know has gone through these changes, or someone who is lovingly supportive of you, someone who can give you their uncut decision and advice, scrap decision advice and suggestions that will help you to see. This is someone that will hold up a mirror to you and allow you to see what you truly are. Okay, so you're no longer playing small. Commit to bringing forth your greatness. You will no longer play small. That's your vibe for the next 6 months. All right, Aquarius, I'm dropping, I'm signing out. I'm getting dramatic with you because I need you to bring all the drama. Rev up your engine, show up 100 times more, rev it up. Bring all the drama to the table. Let's see all the different sides of you you've never even showed us before, because we want to see it. Well, Aquarius, I love you. That was your reading for the next 6 months in your relationship. Your relationship, over these 6 months, you're committing to yourself. Every other person is second place. You're committing to yourself first and foremost, your growth. If you like to book your radio, read the link. It's on my bio. Bees Botanica.com.